Hi, I'm Rolf Harris. Welcome to tonight's Animal Hospital. We've got this little Japanese spitz here who's in a pretty bad way. She's called Trish. How are you getting on, doll?
Not good, Rolf. It really hurts.
Oh, mate. That's not fair, Dinkum.
No, it does. It really, really hurts.
I know, Trish, but I don't know if there's anything that the vets can do about it, and I've got to tell you, buddy, it's choking me up. I mean, is there anything that you'd like to say?
Well, there is something I've always wanted to say on TV.
Well, why don't you tell us that, my doll?
It's Big Brother's Big Mouth.
Yeah, it is! Yeah!
Wiggle your belly.
Rock a pirate pane bum style.
Hello, I'm James Corden.
And I'm Matt Horn. Joining us tonight, LaToya.
Yeah, baby! Yeah. And we've got writer, broadcaster, TV presenter, comedian, model, club promoter, mountaineer, under secretary general to the UN. It's Amy LeMay.
Yeah. And ruining it for everyone else, it's the studio audience. Yeah. We'll be talking to that lot a little later.
Now, we're all learning a lot from these talented housemates. For example, Jeremy has shown us just how a woman should be caressed.
I never take anything. Only a fool maybe takes things for granted. Just because it's here today, it can be gone tomorrow. And that's one thing that you'll never in your life ever have to worry about me.
Just a little too firm, isn't it? Just a bit too there.
Now, all the housemates will be leaving the house on Monday night and coming on this show straight afterwards. I personally had some wonderful news from Amy earlier on today that has certainly given me hope for the occasion. Watch this.
On Monday, we're all gonna fucking be out, so.
Exactly, guys. It's just something.
And I'm gonna be pissed.
Yes! I'm halfway there.
Okay, so, you fancy this girl. You're sure she fancies you back, but she's having a bad day. She's been crying in the bathroom, but you still want her. Now, if all these things are actually happening, don't say this.
Who am I?
Joe Ribbon.
Hello, I'm Chris. I'm from you before you put your makeup on in the morning. Don't happen again, seeing that girl, you ugly. Hey, Daddy, is that you? You got... You don't want a moustache from my daddy. Is that you, moustache? Daddy, is that you? Oh.
Come on, don't mention the tash. Don't mention the tash. Terrible. Now, look, don't just sit there naked, wearing a blindfold and biting down on an orange. Untie yourself and use your phone to tell us your thoughts on Big Brother.
Phone us, text us, or email us your messages via the website.
Now, it's time to profile three more housemates' chances of winning. This time, it's Jeremy, Amy and Amelia. You know Jeremy. He's the racing driver who lies around in bed all day with the 19-year-old contortionist and the fit, posh conceptual artist. I hate him!
I run this show.
And who does he think he is?
I have got fitter since we've been in here.
The next eviction is this evening.
Poor is filled with filth. I'm a nightmare.
What did Amelia's left leg say to her right leg? Oh, nothing, they've never met yet.
It's hard to have comedy in a place where you've been locked in for 20 days.
You want more?
I don't talk to women much.
Well, we've been getting on with the girls quite well today.
I am a huge slap.
I'll do whatever you want.
Jump.
So if I annoy you, just fucking say it. I don't care.
I don't want to be pushed into it, because I'll get fucked off.
Oh, fucking hell.
Are you excited?
I was a whore all day.
Hey, you're a whore all the time, so it doesn't matter.
We're fighting like animals.
Toya, get out. I'm fucking serious.
I really have had enough. I can't believe my brother's gone. I'm just being bitchy. I just can't help it.
How can you say that? It's really mean.
No, don't even question my intelligence, OK? Because I'm more intelligent.
Good stuff. Now, we've decided to call this discussion Is Amy Lamey, Jeremy your enemy, Amelia you're feeling her?
Yeah.
That's hell of a response from something that was actually a bit shit. LaToya, it is a joy to have you here.
Thanks.
Have you taken that hat off since you left?
I didn't have time to brush my hair in the house and I only had like 2 hours sleep this morning.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, wow, the hair's not night. Brushed.
Right. Well, I love it. It's a triumph.
Thanks.
How do you feel being out now?
It's mad. It's still surreal. I can't believe there's people. Like, I ain't seen people in a long time. So. There's people.
Yeah.
But I thought it's much better than I thought it was going to be. Like, uh-huh. The reception yesterday, I couldn't have asked for a better reception, even though I looked a bit, wow. But I was happy with the reception yesterday. It was amazing.
Great. Now, were you surprised that you went instead of Amelia, or did you have any idea of anything?
I weren't sure, because it depends, like, we're two different characters. So if you want, like, I don't know, Toya that runs around messing around all day, or Amelia.
Yeah.
So it was either. So I didn't really know.
It feels like there's two groups in the house.
Yeah.
Did you find it hard to get on with these three, Amelia, Jeremy, and who was the other one?
Amy.
That's the other one. Top of my game.
All right, they're all right separately, but together, wow. But no, I do get along with them, but they sometimes prefer to keep themselves to themselves.
Uh-huh. They seem quite intimidating sometimes as a group.
Yeah.
Can they be?
They, like, if they have a discussion, they'll make sure it's them three, and like some of us will be sitting out, but we'll put in our little penny in a bit, but... Uh-huh. They're all right, they're nice people, but I just got on better with most of the guys, really.
Sure. Amy LeMay.
Yes.
What a dream.
How are you, sweetie?
I'm good. Are you enjoying the show? What do you think of these three that we're talking about now?
Well, you know, I mean, Amelia, you've got to love her. You have to love anybody who can put their ankles behind their earlobes, really. You know, I mean, come on. I can't get enough of that contortion stuff.
In which case, you must love me.
I do, yeah. I also love the chubby ginger one, so yeah.
Oh, there's too many jokes. Carry on.
So anyway, Amelia's all right. I love the contortionist kind of stuff. Jeremy, I just find every time I look at him, he's sitting back on a pillow and you get his kind of like quadruple chin just kind of like gushing out there. So, but Amy, I think everybody likes Amy. I find her fascinating. Do you not?
What about Amelia and Jeremy? What about Amelia and Jeremy? Do you think Amelia and Jeremy is a reason that Amelia stayed in and LaToya went? Do you think that people want that to happen?
Yeah, people want that kind of love interest, I think, and all of that kind of patting and slapping the head and all that kind of caressing his lady, which was a bit dodgy, really. Yeah. I think that, you know, having a love interest in the house, of course, you know, people want to see that. They want to see if it develops or not,
sure.
So...
What do we think out there, Spence?
Have we needed the Jeremy and Amelia thing to spice things up at the show?
No, I think they're playing it right, actually, because, you know, as Amy said, it's perfectly true. You need that romantic thing. But the minute that romantic thing moves further, then the public will turn against them. At the moment, they're supporting them because they want to see what happens. But the minute something does happen, then that's it for
a minute. She chased him. She said when she first went in that her job in the circus is to be the flirt and all things like that. So she... got her claws on Jeremy, she corrupted him. Get her out there.
No way.
But do we think that Amelia can win it?
No.
She can win it. She's a very talented person. She's attractive, yeah, you know, obviously. But I think she's very good. She's a sweet girl as well. I'm not going to deny that there's obviously a streak there. There's something about her. She's a clever girl. But yeah, I hope she wins it, yeah.
What about Jeremy? Does anyone think Jeremy can win it?
Yes.
Yeah?
I think he can because I think he's got a very dry wit. I think he's been very, very polite to most of the housemates. And he speaks his mind. He's the most honest person in there. I want him to win.
Really? Even with the mood swings?
He's got a sense of humour. He's having a laugh. He's just doing what, you know, I think most blokes would do, having a good crack.
Well,
he's got a nice
it's funny you should mention sense of humour because on the phone, we've got a man with a hell of a sense of humour. There's no room here, is there? You're going to have to go on my number. Go on, get on there.
Hey, now, Rob Deering.
Rob Deering's on the phone, everyone. How are you, Rob? How's it going, Rob? And do you like the show so far?
A lot, but do you know just now when you said too many jokes?
Yes.
That wasn't a problem during the stand-up challenge, was it?
Did anyone impress you in that stand-up challenge today?
No, no one impressed me at all. I thought they were very, very bad. I thought Roseanne let them off very lightly.
What about Jay? He was fierce, was he not?
Yeah, he didn't have a whole lot of jokes, but he put a lot of energy up there.
Can we look forward to seeing Jeremy comparing one of your shows soon?
No. But I don't think he'd be too unhappy about that. He didn't look like he was having the time of his life, but then I don't think he ever has.
Rob, we've been talking about Amelia, Amy and Jeremy. Are any of those three winners?
I think, I think of the three of them, I think Amy could win it.
No.
No way.
I don't necessarily want her to, but I just think Amelia, she's quite wet, isn't she? She's quite soft.
Well, Rob, we've got some Amy haters in here, so we're going to go and talk to them.
Thanks for your time. Thanks so much, Rob. You're a star.
So, when Amy's name's been mentioned, there's been a few boos and whatnot. Who wants to talk about her in a negative way? Here he is.
I do not think that she's trying to play any game. I think that she's a natural person, and I think if I was to lay some money, I would give her the vote, because I think she's a natural person, she's a very nice person, and I think she should win.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Some good views.
Thank you for your views. They were good. In 1994, R. Kelly recorded the song Your Body's Calling. Take his advice and get your body to call us on the phone and give us its views. Don't, however, take R's advice on the I Believe I Can Fly thing, though, because you can't. I'm almost certain of that.
Listen, anyone fancy a kickabout? Yeah? Because last week, Matt and I played some footy in here, and some of you weren't that impressed with our skills. So this week, we've got Jeremy Lynch, the star of In the Hands of the Gods, one of the best films you'll ever see. He's one of Europe's best freestylers. He's going to show us how it's done.
While you're looking at us messing about with a ball and Jeremy's brilliance, here's some of our favourite punchlines to jokes. It's the mouthpiece.
Hiya. I just want to say, what's the matter with the British public? People want to see a love story, and that's why LaToya went. Although she was great, Amelia and Jeremy got it going on. One more thing, James Corran, I hope that's your proper surname, I love you.
Oh, I can't put into words how I feel at this moment in time. How on earth has Amelia missed eviction yet again? She's been so bitchy, she's been nasty to LaToya. Can't people see what she's really like? Oh, my goodness gracious me.
I just had to ring to see if anybody else had noticed that Anthony, the night you had, when they had to dress as, the men had to dress as women, how much Anthony looks like Ugly Betty was on the programme of that name. Sorry, it's just an inquiry, but I did think he looked really, really like her. Thank you. Good morning.
Jeremy Lynch, everybody! If you haven't seen Hands of the Gods, it's out on DVD, and it's absolutely incredible. Now, if you're watching in prison, now's the time to turn away. It must be painful to know that the rest of us can go about in consumerist bliss. Whatever you did, it can't have been worth this. Felons, look away now. We'll see you in four. It's the ads!
Situation.
My smile and a secret thing that I can't say.
Skills. Welcome back. Still with us tonight, we've got LaToya.
This bunch of phlegm wads, it's the studio audience.
At lunchtime today, me, James, Yossi Ben-Ayoun and Pliers from Shakademus and Pliers went to the local TGI Fridays to have a working lunch, but it had been burned down. Pliers was furious as he'd been looking forward to having a skins to the brim appetizer. He vowed he wouldn't rest until the arsonists were brought to justice, but promised not to do anything rash. However, later, whilst Yossi was playing Scrabulous, he found a post on the internet from Pliers claiming he would carry out reprisal attacks at a swanky French food fair. Here's our correspondent with this horrible report.
Disgusting.
If a celebrity hijacked this event today, who would you like it to be?
I think I'd like it to be Kylie.
It's s'appelle Daniel Foley.
I think I would like it hijacked by Elmo from Sesame Street.
Elton John.
If it was Johnny Depp, I think I'd go quietly.
James Brown, perhaps. Just think he'd probably tear the place up and get the place jumping, you know what I mean?
What would be a good French phrase for us to use in a hijack situation?
Au secours! Au secours!
Bon.
Bonjour, merci is all I know.
Fermez la porte.
Oui.
Mad.
Le hijack.
And how would you react if this market was hijacked right now?
Probably panic.
I'd go to the wine, I think. You know, you really don't know how much time you have left.
This is all I would say.
Just get involved.
As we did Nate Dogg yesterday, here's Jay-Z, Kanye West, and the notorious B.I.G. John from Edinburgh. Check this and leave.
Oh. I'm Fab Man!
I love Jay so much.
And I'm gay!
Everyone's fucking annoying.
I don't know!
Oh my God, stop stressing out!
What the fuck?
I can't make people laugh.
Get the hint, go home, change your day job. Like, you fucking need another black singer anyway. Please!
Loving it!
I'm loving it!
If you were a burger at McDonald's, you'd be even more gorgeous.
Anthony, put that on now!
My mum always told me not, never to trust someone like wearing a mask and that.
It's an awful drop on my skirt.
Just don't want to. Cuddle it all the time and hold hands all the time.
I'm by far the best friend, but a million times. Oh.
It's nice, isn't it?
I feel like my charisma will just like shine through.
Oh. Ow.
You will become totally under my control.
Oh, shit.
Give him a back rub.
You will therefore win a free pass to the final.
Hey, class, are you?
See you like my mum.
She is too hot to trot.
Who thinks it's John? Put their hand up.
John.
Got myself John, the famous ginger mole.
If it's anyone who deserves it, it's you.
I don't think so.
I'm furniture 90% of the day.
Now, we've called this discussion Anton Yay, Jay or Nay, non to John. It's just dipped.
Doesn't even make sense.
It's just dipped, that
doesn't
one.
Even just make dipped. Sense.
Latoya, thank you so much for being here.
It's
you
right.
Are a D to the ream, a D to the rizzle. Now, let's talk about John.
Yeah.
Now, he obviously had immunity from the start. Was there a sense of hostility from the housemates because of that?
Yeah, everyone was a bit envious of John because obviously he got free pass to the end. But as you got to know John, like, I thought he would have got to the end anyway. Do you know what I mean? Like, John is a great... Yeah. I know, he's generally nice anyway, but...
Yeah, but it, I mean, recently he's been kind of moping about a bit and whinging a little bit. Is it sort of getting to him, or is it because of that feeling around him?
Sometimes he thinks that everyone's paranoid and they all think he's the mole. They've done, like, a Project X thing, mm-hmm. and they all thought he was the mole, but... I don't know. He's all right, but I think because we've all been a lot away for 3.5 weeks, it's kind of getting everyone a bit.
Did you think he was an actor at all?
No.
You didn't?
No, I didn't hear him. He's some of the disgrace to all the dancers. I didn't hear him. I was like, oh, hi, John, hi. So I thought he was just happy with everyone, so I didn't really judge John. So.
Amy, what do you think of John? Do you think he could win it?
I would love to see John win it. I think anybody who's ginger should just win everything. He's ginger. He walks around with this pale skin hanging out of his, you know, dressing gown, and I just, you know, you gotta love him for that, really.
Do you think anyone else deserved the sort of free pass to the end more than him?
Latoya!
Yeah.
I'm gonna
say
Latoya.
She's right here. But actually, I think I'm a big fan of Amy. I know we've already chatted about her, but I think she's quite special, really.
Thank you. Let's talk about our favourite, apart from Latoya. Jay!
We love Jay. Any Jay fans here? You like Jay? You like Jay? Is Jay the most entertaining housemate?
Yeah, when he does his thing where he's being gay, he's really, really cool. And I love him.
What
is it? He was like...
What do you mean, when he's in there every day?
Yeah, he was like, really, I don't know, he's a bit like... But jangly.
He's one of these people, Jay, that I think massively grows on you. Yeah. You kind of oohed and ahed with him in the beginning. After watching the stand-up, I had to go, you know what? You're brilliant. Yeah. After watching that, he was really, really good.
He's a diva with a capital D, and I love
he's
it.
He's a diva with a capital D. Anyone not like Jay? Oh.
he grows
Jay
on
Basher.
You. He grows.
You're Jay Basher.
I'm a Jay Basher. He grows on people like fungus. He really does. I cannot stand. In fact, he reminds me of the policeman from Allo Allo.
I don't...
What? Right, do not say anything about Bostrom.
The Bostrom? Do you mean the greatest...
Can we get this guy out? Let's get rid of him. Let's get rid of him.
Get out.
Off you go. Come on. Get out. Off you go.
No one takes Bostrom down. No one takes Bostrom down.
Oh, dear.
No way. No way.
Can Jay win it? Can Jay win it?
Now, listen, quickly. Anthony, we've all loved Anthony for him, but we saw a different side of him today. Can he still win it after today? No?
See, personally, being a girl, I know the girls whole love that Anthony's beautiful. Personally, I think he's slightly overrated.
Latoya, can Anthony win it?
Yeah.
Amy,
no way.
Will Anthony win it?
Way too annoying.
Then who's going to win it? Who's going to win it, Amy?
Amy.
Whoa!
Wow. Big time.
Right, that's it. We're going to knock off now.
We're going to say a big thank you to goodbye to our guests, Latoya and Amy LeMay.
And their fundamentalist opinions have been making this area of the studio a no-go area. It's the audience.
It's the last eviction tomorrow, so we're on at 10:35. We're nearly done, and I promise you're going to miss us when we're gone. Stay tuned to E4. Have a kip during Friends and knock one out during Hollyoaks. We'll be back in a bit.
Amy, Callista, Amelia, Jay, Jeremy and Nathan face eviction from the Big Brother house. Who goes? You decide.
To evict a housemate, call 09011-2122, followed by 01 for Amy, 03 for Callista, 04 for Amelia, 06 for Jay, 07 for Jeremy, 11 for Nathan.
At least 10 people from each call will be donated to charity, details of which can be found at channel4.com/Big Brother.